Are you a morning person or a night owl?
It has never happened that I love to get up in the morning, but yes, if I had to see a good sunrise, then maybe yes. So, but remaining awake late at night is comfortable for me. So,
are you a coffee person or a tea guy?
I've been a salesperson, so even phenyl is also fine. So for me, it doesn't matter if it's coffee or tea. No, as long as I have a good conversation, I think that is more important.
How do you run a meeting?
It's pretty simple. First and foremost, be clear about what the meeting is about. No, you should not hold a meeting for sake of a meeting. Second, be clear about what are we wanting to discuss. Stick to the point. Hear views of everyone, and conclude the meeting. Have a discussion. Don't try to fix the next meeting date for that meeting, because then that's a huge time wastage. So being very precise about it and cutting out all the noise and crap, and diversion from it, and listening to all views on that particular point and coming to a decision is the way meeting should be conducted.
Would you rather go to watch a cricket final match in a stadium with Mr. Sanjeev Bajaj or sit and discuss life with Mr. Rahul Bajaj?
That's an interesting question. See, both has its own charm. I have always loved to sit and discuss with people, and learn from them and their experiences. Mr. Rahul Bajaj obviously has a huge variety of experiences. So for me, that would always be more enriching. And second, from a sports perspective, I have always believed in playing a sport. So I'm not one of those people who love to watch a sport. Yeah. So I believe that it's better that if I pick up a cricket bat, and pick up a few friends and whatever stupidity I may do with that bat, but to me that would give me more of a kick, But yes, spending time with people, listening to them. And Mr. Rahul obviously has been an icon in the industry, so from him there's a lot of learning. But even somebody like you, somebody like, who's just a newcomer also, I love to spend time and listen to them, because that to me is far more enriching than anything else.
What do you do in your free time?
How do you define free time? Is what it is like. I think it when we use the word free time, the problem is, Vikram, it means the other time we are like a slave. Yeah. So to me, it's not so. I would say every moment is a free time for me. See, when you say a free means the other time you are like a slave. Why should you be a slave? In a free time also, what you do some work, right? You do some operation sports. Simply when you do work, you do work. So to me, there's nothing called a free time or a slavery time. Every moment is a free time, I think it's very constructive for me at all points of time.
What do you prefer, texting or talking?
Talking.
What do you prefer, dawn or dusk?
Because I'm not a very morning person, so I think dusk and sunset has always intrigued me and I found it very fascinating. But the sunrise also, but I have to get up really good early morning, to catch hold of some good sunrises. But so we can say dusk. Yeah.
How many cups of tea do you drink in a day?
It depends on how many people come to visit me who ask tea. So I have no such requirement. I think when earlier as a hardcore salesperson, and go for meetings, and now the people are so conscious for health, I think people normally just have green tea. In my earlier times, people had normal tea. So you end up having 15-20 cups, depending on how many meetings you had. So it's not about how many cups I wanted to have, it's about people who visit me, and that is how it is.
Would you climb a mountain or jump from a plane?
Luckily, I've done both, and both have been very exhilarating, I think. I remember when I jumped from 15,000 feet, you're over the clouds and you're falling, free fall, yeah. It's amazing how you first look at the clouds and then you go through the clouds and then you look at the clear, those times you could see some water and some land, and then when your parachute opens, So it's a different experience altogether, though in seconds. It's a short experience, but very exhilarating. Climbing a mountain, I think it's a test of your level of fitness, and it's a journey you should enjoy. It's not the when you get to the top, obviously you feel very happy you have achieved and you're on the top and you have a very good view. But the entire journey is something which is unbelievable. So I've been lucky to do both, and I can do both again.
What's something you could eat for a week straight?
So I don't know, how do you call it? It's called jhalmudi in Calcutta. It's made from rice puffs and you put in a lot of stuff together. And some warm tea in the wooden, in the mud cups that you have. No? I think so if I'm traveling, this is my favorite snack which I'd be having. And the rest is just lentil and rice, so it's not very complicated.
Which superpower would you want? Invisibility or super strength?
None. I'm very happy the way I am. What do I do with a superpower? If you're invisible also, what do I do? I don't want to go and, you know, kind of spy on someone. Or if I get super strength, what do? I have enough people, I have strong team members. And if I collectively put it all together, we already have that super strength. No? Why should I want it for myself only?